gummy bear beats. Like you don't want that on your beat, okay? Your boy needs a haircut, but I don't have time. Stay hydrated, people. This is a very serious video, okay? Woo! What a smart rabbit gang. What if you buy what if you don't buy the beat and the song blows up? What if you made a song to a beat, but you didn't buy the beat? What's gonna happen? I'm gonna tell y'all today. I'm Rob Level, this is Smart Rapper, and you gonna be shocked at the actual answer that I'm gonna teach you today right after the intro.
Gang!
I do this full time, bitch. I do this full time. Every day, day.
I do this full time, bitch. I do this full time.
Every day, day.
Stay up on my grind, bitch.
All day, day.
Stay up on my grind. I do this full time, bitch.
Here's what's generally gonna happen. If you create, like, you just make a smash. You make a fire ass song, right? Let's say you make a fire ass song and you hadn't bought the beat. This is generally what happens, okay? A beat maker's not gonna come at you and go, yo, bro, I made that beat, I want my cut. Mm-mm. They don't have to, okay? And today I'm gonna teach something using blurred lines, okay? Now, yes, Pharrell, you know, made the beat to blurred lines, but, you know, he also had accidentally or taken a melody or a sample from Marvin Gaye, which is, you know, Marvin Gaye's freaking, it's fucking Marvin Gaye, you know, legendary. So like when you take something from them or even any beat maker in general, what they do is they wait until after your record makes as much money as it could possibly make. Like why would, let's put it like this. Why would a beat maker stop the progression of your record blowing up when he's gonna get paid from every dollar you make? He doesn't wanna stop that. He wants that thing to make $100 million. Okay, because he knows when he goes to sue you, which is going to happen, he's gonna get his money. But at the same time, it's not that huge of a deal, except for he's gonna get more money than he would have got if he would have bought the beat. Okay, that's where that comes in. But first, let's talk about this, okay? But the Marvin Gaye thing. Now, Blurred Lines made like $36 million in total, okay? I'm gonna read this right here, because we got this here. All right, it made around $36 million. Then right when it was done buzzing, it had almost all the money it was possibly going to make. Its run had, you know, fallen off. It was a huge record, but then, you know, it started going out, right? They got sued for just this little tiny part. Marvin Gaye's family won $5.3 million, okay? This was the deal that was made. $5.3 million, okay? And 50% of all future royalties of that song, which is gonna be a bunch more million dollars, because that song it's a smash, right? So it'll definitely make more money. All right, so it's like I said here, like they're gonna wait for that peak moment to sue you. After the record is like up here, right, and then it starts losing it, and it's like it's no longer gonna be like the current relevant song, that's when they'll sue you, okay? And this is inevitable, because they deserve to get their cut of the money. They made the beat, okay? Or, you know, let's just pretend like they're the only person who made the beat and you just recorded a song over it, okay? They deserve to get their publishing for that, because they are considered a songwriter on the song. They did help you write that song, realistically. So they're gonna get their cut of the money. And if you don't buy the beat, you don't have a lease. Well, here's the thing is, if you had a lease and it blew up, you're way past the lease. You're way past a premium lease, a pro lease, and I think even though it's called unlimited lease, I think you're still even past an unlimited lease on a lot of the way the contracts are read, because when a record gets that big, like if you go to Billboard, like top 10, like they're gonna get their money from you. They're gonna be able to sue you and say, I own this much, it was in this movie, it was in this, it was over here, it was in these commercials. Like they're gonna get their money. They're going to sue you and they're gonna get it. And that's not a bad thing though, because they do deserve it, and you know they deserve it. But I wanted you to know that's what would happen if your song blew up and you hadn't paid for the beat. So what I recommend is you go and you buy beats. If you can, if you feel like your song is a smash, if you're like, yo, this shit is so hard, I don't ever wanna get sued for this, I wanna own as much of this as possible, go buy the exclusive, okay? Buy the exclusive. I spent, yes, $3,000 yesterday buying beats, talking back and forth with beat makers, making deals with them to buy the exclusives. Now, when you buy an exclusive, this is interesting, right? Some of the exclusives from the beat makers gave me all the, I get all the royalties. I get all, they gave up their publishing and I own the beat 100%, it is mine, okay? And then some of them, they keep 50% of the publishing, okay? So I would still get 50% of the publishing, and I'm not gonna go into that, but there's 100% songwriting and there's 100% publishing, and they're two different things when you have a song, okay? And I'll do a video on that some other time. But they still are gonna get 50% of the publishing, even though I bought the exclusive for the beat, because they still are credited as a songwriter, because they did make the beats, right? The thing is though, is that the beats get taken out of the beat store, which is a big deal, okay? So if I wanna buy these beats because I don't want nobody else downloading them or making songs to the beat that I already made a fire ass song to, right? So that's another reason I went and bought all these beats. Nobody else can make songs to them anymore. I have them and I own exclusive rights to the beat, okay? Anyways, that's how it's usually gonna work. But let's also talk about another circumstance. Let's say the beat maker is a complete and he does not like you and he does not like your song that you put up on the beat. There are some things that could happen if you didn't buy a lease, okay? They could potentially be like, I own this beat, take the song down, which will happen. This can potentially happen. If they own the beat and you didn't buy a lease, they are allowed to say, I own the rights to that beat. He doesn't have any rights that he didn't buy a lease or anything, and there's no proof that he did. I want the song taken down. You don't want that happening. What if you have, and I mean, even if your song has 10,000 views on it, and you worked really hard to get those 10,000 views, wouldn't that just suck so much if they fucking did that? I mean, of course they'd be an asshole to do that, but at the same time, aren't you an asshole for not buying a lease, for not just giving them $20? Yeah, and by then they're gonna be like, oh bro, I'll give you $20. They'll be like, no, it's too late, because they're already mad at you. You know what I'm saying? So that's why, it's another reason I highly recommend that you at least buy a basic lease for things, okay? And here's are some reasons why you should buy at least a basic lease for a beat, okay? Number one, you're gonna feel much safer posting your songs online. You're gonna feel comfortable posting your song online knowing that it's not gonna get removed, okay? Because you paid for the lease. Number two, generally on a lease, the tag is taken off, okay? So it's not like, Skizzy on the beat. You know, I don't want that shit in the beginning of the song. You sound so amateur when I hear Skizzy on the beat or whatever the fuck, whatever beat maker tag is on the beat. Unless it's like an 808 Mafia tag or like a Mike Will Made It. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's different. Those are okay. You want those on your beats. But you don't want ones where it's like the person has no idea, like gummy bear beats. Like you don't want that on your beat, okay? And number three, why you should buy the lease is, like I said, the beat maker, the producer is getting paid as he should. Hope this helped you today. Hope you became a smarter rapper, which is the whole point and intention of this entire channel and me helping you. Anyways, you know what time it is.
I got this right here, man. It's time for word of the day, new words. You can say new words for your rhymes and for your wordplay. By the time you leave this video, you'll be smarter than you was before.
This is so stupid.
This is probably one of my favorite words in a long time. It's a word used to describe people who are habitually complaining or whining. And I know you know those people. You probably got them at work. Hopefully you don't have them at home because you don't have to deal with them. But the word is querulous. That's a great word. I'll spell it out for you. And a fantastic quote of the day that I think everyone can really, really appreciate is, people change and forget to tell each other. That's by Lillian Hellman. That says so much, because of course you're not even the same person you were 2 weeks ago. I know I'm not. We change, and people don't even know.
All right, y'all, I'm Rob Lovell, this is Smart Rapper. Hit me with a like, hit me with a comment. Please leave your four bars below for today using the word of the day inside of your rhymes, okay? Because it's gonna help the word stick. There's no point in trying to learn a word if you're not really learning the word, okay? Hearing the word is not the same as learning it. So writing it and putting it inside of a line is gonna help you remember the word, especially since you generally remember your lyrics, don't you? So that's a good way to do it. Hit that subscribe button. When you hit subscribe, hit the little bell, because it's going to notify you every time I release a new video so you can become a smarter rapper. And I release a new video every single day on this channel. We've over like 650 videos on this channel now. Ridiculous, I know, right? A lot of videos. And we're only growing like crazy, buddy. We're only growing like crazy, okay? Now, lastly, I do have an A&R contacts list. You guys can sign up, get those for free, get like music industry contacts and everything else like that. All those links are below. My songwriting course, my hip hop, 200 plus hip hop blog email list, my rap flow course, all that stuff, how to find your rap voice, all that stuff is below. All right, now check out these videos and check out those links in the description, okay? And at least buy a basic lease, okay? If you guys are gonna be using people's beats, and trust me, I know, I've been at where I was way too fucking broke to be able to even buy a $20 beat lease. And I've lost a lot of songs because I wasn't able to buy the beat lease. And then when I went to go buy it to get the tag off, the song was already sold. And it's like, fuck, I gotta release it with the tag on it. Like, I've been there, okay? Like, so anyways, check out these videos. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Keep hustling. Spend that 20 bucks.